In this illustration, we intend to simulate the arc welding on a pipe using Dflux Subroutine in the Abaqus software. The welding torch moves round the pipe in a circular path. The movement of heat source is based on the Goldack's double ellipsoid model, and you can observe this model in this picture in this manner. And finally click on OK. I'll then click on Create Section, select Solid Homogeneous, Continue and OK. Select Couple Temp Displacement, Continue. The analysis would be done in nonlinear form. Time period is equal to 125.67 seconds. Actually, the time period of welding process is 125.67 seconds. Then I will click on Create Boundary Condition. From here, select Initial Step, then Symmetry and Anti-symmetry, and Continue. I will select these surfaces down here. Since our model is symmetric and we've simulated half of the model, so we should use the x-symmetric. So I will tick on the x-symmetric boundary condition and OK. Select these lines. Done. Consider the number of 4 elements for them. And OK. Then I'll click on seed part and enter approximate global size as 0.002 meters and OK. Finally, I'll click on mesh part and yes. Select Abaqus User Subroutines Reference Manual. Here I select Abaqus Standard and then select Dflux Subroutine in this manner. Here the manner of writing Dflux Subroutine has been explained. I will select Dflux Subroutine, copy and paste that in the Visual Studio software in this manner. We should use the body heat flux for simulating of the welding process, and we will use the Goldack double ellipsoid model for defining the body heat flux. Also, we will use Dflux Subroutine in order to define the Goldack double ellipsoid model. In this question, the welding speed unit should be radian per second. We use this relation for converting the linear velocity to angular velocity. Here, omega is the angular velocity, the unit of which is the radian per second, r is the radius, the unit of which is meter, v is the linear velocity, the unit of which is meter per second, and the angular velocity is equal to 0.05 radian per second, which has been distinguished here. Continue. Here select User Subroutine File and here click on animate. I'll select the equivalent plastic strain from here, click on animate. Here you can observe the expansion and a swelling having been created on the pipe. As you observe, the pipe becomes expanded as it is quite clear here. Here you can observe the elliptical shape having been created on the model. This elliptical shape has been displayed here in form of colored contours as well. Plot. Here I right click on the diagram, on edit, and select these two columns, copy them, and paste here. I'll select these two columns, select this diagram from the insert menu, here the diagram of the axial residual stress have been drawn for the inner surfaces of the pipe. Here you can observe hoop residual stress for the inner surfaces of the pipe. And here the axial residual stress is for the inner surfaces of the pipe, which can be observed here. Here, the axial residual stress is for the outer surfaces that can be observed. Here there is a hoop residual stress that can be observed.